Hi everyone, Assalamualaikum. In this video, we are going to discuss example 2 under continuity. Given gx is a piecewise function ax minus 2 for domain x less or equals to 2, gx equals to 4x plus b for domain 2 less than x less or equals to 3, and gx equals to x squared minus 9 over x minus 3 for domain x greater than 3. A, given that limit x approaches to gx equals to 6, find the values of a and b. And b, hence, determine whether the function is continuous at x equals to 3, right? First, let me discuss how to find limit x approaches 2 from the left and from the right, and limit x approaches 3 from the left and from the right. Okay? From this domain, x less or equals to 2, we can find limit x approaches 2 from the left dx because x less or equals to 2 means 2 from the left, right? So, to find limit x approaches 2 from the left dx, we can use this function, okay? Because this function for this domain, right? And then, from 2 less than x, okay? If we read backward, we can read as x greater than 2. X greater than 2 means 2 from the right. So, we can find limit x approaches 2 from the right dx based on this domain. And from this domain, we can use this function. Okay, means that to find limit x approaches 2 from the right dx, we can use gx equals to 4x plus b, right? From x less or equals to 3, we can find limit x approaches 3 from the left dx because x less or equals to 3 means 3 from the left, okay? So, we use the same function, which is 4x plus b, okay? So, in this case, limit x approaches 2 from the right dx and limit x approaches 3 from the left dx, we use the same function, which is 4x plus b, right? Right, from domain x greater than 3, okay, we can find limit x approaches 3 from the right dx. Since this domain refers to this function, so we use gx equals to x squared minus 9 over x minus 3, right? We look at question A. Given that limit x approaches to gx equals to 6, find the values of a and b, right? Basically, to find the given constant here, we can use this formula. Okay, since we have limit x approaches 2 here, so we can use formula limit x approaches 2 from the left dx equals to limit x approaches 2 from the right dx. Okay, when we use this formula, to find limit x approaches 2 from the left dx, we use gx equals to ax minus 2. So, we can write limit x approaches 2 from the left and then we replace gx equals to ax minus 2. Okay, and then limit x approaches 2 from the right dx, we use this function. Okay, so we can replace gx equals to 4x plus b. Right, after that, we can use direct substitution. So, we get 2. We substitute into whatever x here, so we get 2a minus 2. And then right hand side, we get 4 times 2 equals to 8 and then plus b, right? Limit x approaches 2 from the left here means that we replace positive 2 into whatever x, not negative 2. Because negative sign here means 2 from the left, right? And after we use direct substitution, now we can see that we have two constant or two variables, which is a and b. So, we need to find another equation to solve. Okay. Okay, the best way is from here, given limit x approaches to dx equals to 6. So we can use limit x approaches to from the left dx equals to 6 and limit x approaches to from the right dx equals to 6. Since limit x approaches to dx equals to limit x approaches to from the right dx. So we can straightforward use the given value here. Right? Because if we use this formula, we need to find two variables. Means we need to find another equation to find two variables. Right? So the best way is we separate one by one like this. Okay? If the limit is given. Okay? The value of limit is given. Right? For limit x approaches to from the left dx, from here, we replace dx equals to ax minus 2. So we get this. Okay, limit x approaches 2 from the left. And then after we replace dx equals to ax minus 2. So we get this. And then equals to 6. Okay, after that, we can use direct substitution. We replace 2 into whatever x here. Right? So we get 2a minus 2 equals to 6. Then we have 2a equals to 8 and a equals to 4. Okay? And then for limit x approaches to from the right dx, okay? From here, we replace dx equals to 4x plus b. Okay, so we get this. Limit x approaches to from the right. And then we replace dx equals to 4x plus b equals to 6. Okay, from here, we can use direct substitution. So we get this. Okay, remember, after we use direct substitution, no more limit expression. Okay, we plug in 2 into whatever x here. So we get 4 times 2 plus b equals to 6. So we have 8 plus b equals to 6 and b equals to 6 minus 8 equals to negative 2. So the values of a equals to 4 and the value of b equals to negative 2. Alright? Now we look at question b. Hence, determine whether the function is continuous at x equals to 3. Right? From the previous slide, we get a equals to 4 and b equals to negative 2. Okay, if we substitute a equals to 4 and b equals to negative 2 here, so we get this. Okay, dx equals to 4x minus 2. And for the second row here, after we substitute b equals to negative 2, so we get 4x minus 2. Okay. We look at this. The functions are equal. Okay, this is coincident actually, right? To determine whether the function is continuous at x equals to 3, we need to pass 3 conditions. Okay, the first condition, g3, must define. We use g3 here because the given function is dx, and we want to determine whether the function is continuous at x equals to 3, right? The second condition is limit x approaches 3, dx must exist, okay? And then the third condition, limit x approaches 3, dx must equals to g3, right? To find g3, which dx should we use from here, okay? We look at this, x less or equals to 3. We have equal sign here. So, means that to find g3, we need to use this dx, right? So, use dx equals to 4x minus 2. And then g3 equals to, we substitute 3 into whatever x here. So, we get 4 times 3 minus 2 equals to 12 minus 2, which is equals to 10. Right? Now we continue with condition number two. Limit x approaches 3gx must exist. Alright, to determine whether limit exists or does not exist, first we need to find limit from the left. Okay, in this case, we need to find limit x approaches 3 from the left gx. Okay, and then from here, which gx should we use? Okay, we look at here, x less or equals to 3. Okay, x less than 3 here means 3 from the left. So we can find limit x approaches 3 from the left gx using this gx, right? So from here, we replace gx equals to 4x minus 2. Okay, now we have limit x approaches 3 from the left 4x minus 2. Then we can use direct substitution. We replace 3 into whatever x here. Okay, we substitute positive 3, not negative 3, because negative here means from the left. Alright? Alright, so from here, 4 times 3 minus 2. After we use direct substitution, no more limit expression. Okay, then after we solve, we get equals to 10. Okay, 12 minus 2 equals to 10. Right? Right. Now we done find limit x approaches 3 from the left dx, which is equals to 10, right? After that, we need to find limit x approaches 3 from the right gx, okay? From here, which gx should we use, okay? So we look at here, okay? We have x greater than 3, okay? X greater than 3 here means 3 from the right. So we can use limit x approaches 3 from the right gx using this function, right? Then we replace gx equals to x squared minus 9 over x minus 3. So we get limit x approaches 3 from the right x squared minus 9 over x minus 3, right? From the previous slide, we get this. Limit x approaches 3 from the right gx equals to limit x approaches 3 from the right x squared minus 9 over x minus 3. From here, let's say we use direct substitution to solve this limit. Okay, we get 3 squared, which is 9 minus 9, and then 3 minus 3. So we get 0 over 0, which is indeterminate. So in this case, we cannot use direct substitution to solve this limit. Okay, we need to factorize this quadratic function, right? Right, so after we factorize, so we get this. Limit x approaches 3 from the right, and then x plus 3 times x minus 3 over x minus 3. From here, we have same factor in numerator and denominator. So we can cancel it, right? After that, we get limit x approaches 3 from the right, x plus 3. Then from here, we can use direct substitution. We substitute 3 into whatever x here. Okay, and remember, after we use direct substitution, no more limit expression. So we get 3 plus 3, which is equals to 6, right? We recall back how to determine whether limit exists or does not exist. The first step, we need to find limit x approaches c from the left fx. In this case, we need to find limit x approaches 3 from the left gx, right? And after that, step 2, we need to find limit x approaches c from the right fx. In this case, we need to find limit x approaches 2 from the right gx, right? Right, after that, step 3, we need to check whether limit from the left equals to limit from the right, okay? From the previous slide, we get limit from the left equals to 10, okay? We get limit x approaches 3 from the left gx equals to 10, okay? From here, we get limit x approaches 3 from the right gx equals to 6, right? So when we compare, okay, we can write limit x approaches 3 from the left dx, okay, 6 and 10 here, not equals to limit x approaches 3 from the right dx, right? After we check whether limit from the left is it equals to limit from the right, then we can conclude whether limit exists or does not exist. Okay, so from here, we can say that limit x approaches 3 dx does not exist. Alright? Got it? We recall back to determine whether the function is continuous. We need to follow these three conditions. The first condition, fc, must define. In this case, g3 must define. Okay? And then condition number two, limit x approaches cfx must exist. In this case, limit x approaches 3 dx must exist. But we get limit x approaches 3 dx does not exist. So means that we fail condition number 2. Okay? We suppose continue with condition number 3. Limit x approaches 3 dx is it equals to the value of g3. But since we fail condition number 2, so no need to proceed with condition number 3. Alright? So we just give the conclusion, therefore, dx or the function is discontinuous at x equals to 3 because condition number 2 or one of the condition is failed. Alright? So we no need to proceed with condition number 3. Right? Got it? Coming up next, continuity example 3. You can subscribe, like and share to support this channel. Thank you for watching. Stay tuned. Bye. Assalamualaikum.